Smart cities has been bubbling along for a number of years now. Cars, transportation, mobility is fundamental to the smart city. We've got cars driving around the road network, gathering loads of data. What are we doing with that data? Nothing. So Streamr can come along and unlock the value of that car data, and also via its network, help cars to talk to other cars, to talk to roadside units, to talk to the infrastructure that's running the road network. And then what we're also doing is demonstrating the value of a data economy and how a data economy can actually work on the road network.
So first thing is we need a real electric vehicle. And the way we use it is we have access the CAN bus, which is the central network of the car, to be able to access the complete data which the car is producing. And since Bosch has real deep knowledge of all the systems and all the components in the car, we really can make sense out of that data, combining it to maybe new use cases in the future.
So as you were driving around Zurich, the car has been generating data, and that's the data you can see now. So this is just a raw stream. And if you open now the Streamr canvas, we can see the data in a more visual way. So we can see charts for the speed, steering wheel angle velocity, and also we can see our position here on the map.
So cars are effectively computers on wheels, applications, gathering lots of data. Streamr's part in all of that is the hub. So it interconnects all this data, whether it's an IoT device, whether it's a car, multiple cars, and also the infrastructure running the city. So imagine if you had all the cars driving around Zurich all connected and all talking to each other and actually getting all of that intelligence out. What you can then do is actually make people move around the city more effectively.
So what we want to show with this app is that any car, even an older car, can join the network and benefit from other drivers' data. On the app, I can see there is an obstacle on a road. It generated based on the data from the car ahead of us. Now I can slow down and avoid it safely. This app, it's a bit like a Waze, but everyone gets paid for their data. Even older cars can install this app on the tablet or on the smartphone. What really excites me about this app, that it's unlocking the potential of the data that wasn't utilized until now. And it also enables drivers to earn money for their data.
I think at the moment we have really that challenging situation that we do not really have fair and open markets with data as it was planned in the beginning of the internet. What we see today is we have more and more monopolistic platforms. I think we have the chance now to change that situation a little bit.
We've had the web of data interconnecting. We've now got the internet of cars. We can create something very collaborative, very open, where all sorts of car companies could connect and all sorts of organizations. But the point is, it's collaborative and it's an open ecosystem, underpinned with a flow of real-time data, very fast, with very fast decisions. And that's what I'm excited about, because we're now actually taking the web of data to the next stage and bringing cars, which are amazing devices, into the mix.